Hello, I'm Michael Lawless. I'm here with Professor Colin Chan and Professor Gerard Sutton. And the question we've got to answer today, or this afternoon, is why do people have laser eye surgery? It's a pretty broad question. I might go to you, Colin, first. What of the patients you see, why do they have this done?
Well, I can probably speak for myself under circumstance because I had laser Gerard and while back, but one of the most common reasons they say it is because they feel very dependent on their glasses, and that particularly is pertinent for someone who's maybe worn glasses from quite a young age, even primary school, and they can't remember a time where they didn't have glasses, and they have this horrible feeling that if I lose the glasses, particularly if I'm in the water or surf or something, I'm just completely helpless. And I think this actually really strikes home with people, and that's why I did laser myself about at this age, when they have young children. Have a child born, suddenly you're thinking, well, it's not just my life I'm looking after, it's someone else's. And if they're in the beach or surf and I lose track of them and my contact lenses wash out or my glasses wash out, very bad situation. So that's one of the most common reasons people will tell me they want to. They don't want this feeling of dependency.
Yeah, thanks, Colin. What about you, Gerard? What do you think what are your patients coming for?
Well, I think that there are a broad range of reasons that people want to have laser eye surgery, but what they're all really looking for is something that's going to actually improve their life, and specifically their enjoyment of life. And as Colin said, often that's there are lifestyle reasons for that. But in my case, and Michael did my laser surgery many years ago, for me it was a problem with my sporting activities, and I was becoming presbyopic. That means I was beginning to need reading glasses, and I didn't want to be dependent on them all the time. But many people come in because they have specific needs. They want to be able to ski without glasses, swim without glasses, play sport without glasses, or they might even just be sick of putting contact lenses in every day. But for each of those reasons, it's about trying to make their life easier and better. And I think that that's what laser eye surgery can offer.
Thanks, Gerard. How about to both Colin and Gerard, what about this scenario that the first port of call is glasses as a teenager, as a young person, when you're first diagnosed with an optic error? You wear glasses for a period, then you wear contact lenses for a period, and then you almost graduate to having laser eye surgery. Is that a natural progression? Do you see that? And where do the contact lens and contact lens tolerance issues fit in with this decision process? Let's switch it back to you, Paul.
I think the patients I do see, the majority do have that natural progression. Sometimes you will get someone who goes from wearing nothing straight to laser surgery, but that's the minority, that's not the norm. And the classic scenario is a patient that has worn contact lenses, worn them for maybe 5 to 10 years plus, experiencing increasing problems with tolerating them, dryness, irritation, because you know, as good as contact lenses are, they ultimately are a foreign thing in your eye, and the body gradually rejects that. And essentially, there was this very interesting study which actually did look again at that crossover of risk and of laser surgery versus contact lens risk. And once you've worn contact lenses for long enough, then essentially having laser eye surgery is theoretically safer. So I think patients begin to realize that that's actually they realize that contact lenses are not going to be there forever for them.
Okay. I think we've Colin's answered that so well, I'm going to ask you a different question.
No problem.
What about at the other extreme? Because there's laser eye surgery and then there's lens surgery, lens or early cataract surgery. What about this natural progression from you've always been normal, you're 45 or 50, and you can't read anymore, you wear reading glasses, and then you get to be your mid-late 50s and suddenly you're in multifocal glasses. Is that a natural progression? You then move to lens replacement.
Yeah, I think it is for a lot of people. And what we are seeing is that a lot more people have had friends who've had that sort of surgery and are spectacle independent. And so it's a very attractive, you know, when you get to that mid-50s, early 60s, to be able to, you know, get out of those glasses again. But for some people, they're happy to wear glasses and contact lenses, and, you know, laser eye surgery or lens surgery is not for them. But certainly, I think it is a progression. And the other thing that I'm seeing in my practice now is that patients who had laser surgery in their 30s are now in their 50s and are now seeking an alternative, and often that lens surgery is an option for them. So, you know, often that journey that you talk about is not just from going from glasses to contact lenses to some sort of surgery, but going from a laser eye surgery to a lens surgery. And I think that it's great to be able to offer these patients something else when they get older.
Yeah. I think both Colin and Gerard have answered the question, and they haven't mentioned that people have laser eye surgery or lens replacement for cosmetic reasons. And there are, it's very rare that people do this for reasons of vanity or cosmesis. I think vanity makes the world go round, but it's not the reason people seek this surgery. It's actually the reverse. People want this because they want to function better. Mm-hmm. And the time I see that most frequently, because I'm a consultant to the Australian Defence Force, and people in certain jobs, commando units, the SAS, defence divers, it's just impossible to function as well as they can with glasses and contact lenses. And some jobs, some sports, basically, if you want to perform to your best, you've got to have it done. Mm-hmm. And that's just the way it is. Mm. But it's the complete opposite to doing it for reasons of vanity. Mm. So I think the reasons are as diverse as the population is diverse. But hopefully we've given you some idea of why people are coming in. Thank you. Thanks, Gerard. And thanks, Colin.
Thanks, Michael.